Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us. We apologize for the delay and starting a little later than planned. Today we're going to be discussing with Dr. Reza Shahim minimally and micro-invasive spine surgeries. Dr. Shahim, if you would, just give us a little information about where you have clinic and how long you've been practicing.
Thank you, Tina. I'm a neurosurgeon at Arkansas Surgical Hospital. Sorry, surgery is running a little late today. That's why I'm here a few minutes late. I've been with Arkansas Surgical Hospital since it opens. We perform a combination of orthopedic and spine surgery at the Arkansas Surgical Hospital. And we specialize in musculoskeletal injuries, knees, hips, back, neck surgeries.
Well, let's begin the presentation information by describe for us a typical patient, someone who might need spine surgery.
So most of the patients that I see in the clinic are there mainly because of pain. They have neck pain, back pain, or spine pain. Majority of them can be treated non-surgically. Typically, the patients that are best candidate for surgery are the ones that have either severe pain or they have neurological deficit. And neurological deficit are things like weakness and numbness that affect your arms or legs, or severe pain. So if the pain is very severe or you have a deficit, which is like arm weakness or leg weakness or numbness, then you probably should be considered for surgery rather than going through non-surgical treatment. If the pain is tolerable and if you don't have a deficit, then you're probably a candidate for conservative management or non-surgical treatment, which is we offer most of the patients that we treat surgically have failed non-surgical treatments. But the primary indication for surgery in the spine usually is severe pain or neurological deficit that's progressive, that's getting worse over time.
So we hear a lot about minimally invasive surgery, microsurgeries. So how does that impact spine surgery and what sort of innovations have been made in microsurgeries?
So if the patients have already failed non-surgical treatment, so most patients that I see have a combination of disc disease, arthritis, spinal stenosis, or a pinched nerve, or some combination of that. Typically, if the patients are not in severe pain, we will offer them non-surgical treatments, which includes physical therapy, taking medications, receiving spinal injections. And the spinal injections could be considered kind of a minimal invasive treatment, but probably a large population of patients over time fail these treatments. Maybe as much as half of the patients will fail a combination of these non-surgical treatments. And then the surgeries are the next option. Over the last few years, the microsurgical techniques have advanced, which means that we do less invasive surgeries. Essentially, that means that the incisions are smaller, blood loss is less, trauma to the tissue is less, and so the recovery is quicker, pain is usually less in certain group of patients, and the outcomes are generally better and the complications are less because the surgery is performed through a small incision with less time to recovery, basically. There's many different ways to do the surgeries. What you want to look for are the right surgery for the right patient, and if patients qualify for minimal invasive surgery, not everybody will qualify, but a lot of patients that have a pinched nerve or a spinal stenosis will qualify for microsurgical treatments, which are safer, I think, better treatments than the traditional surgical treatments.
And do we do these microsurgeries here at ASH?
So yeah, we do perform microsurgical treatments in the spine at ASH and at Arkansas Surgical Hospital and have for a long time. We would need to see you and see your MRI and see whether or not you qualify for it. And we generally do offer multiple treatment options. Again, when I see a patient, I usually will go through a list of treatment options. And these surgeries are elective, so I want the patients to be involved in decision making. There's a lot of patients who want to be managed non-surgically, which is fine. And they can go through an array of treatments. And then if they fail And if the symptoms are severe enough, then they should consider microsurgical treatments.
I see you've brought a model here today, and I had some questions about a microdiscectomy.
So the one of the common problems that we see is back pain related to a pinched nerve. And the pinched nerve could be, in this model, for example, the area where the nerves run in the spine is a bony area with a canal or a tube inside of the spine. And the nerves are these yellow things that are coming out of the spine, essentially wires that are coming out of the spine that go down the leg. So if you get a pinched nerve, it's usually due to a disc herniation or a slip disc or a bulging disc. Essentially, parts of the disc material pushes up against the nerve and causes sciatica or pain down the leg or severe back or hip pain. And then the other common cause of this kind of pain is spinal stenosis, which is narrowing of the area in the spine where the nerves run. So you can get a pinched nerve from disc ruptures or slip disc, or you can get a pinched nerve from spinal stenosis. Either one of them can be treated surgically. The outcomes of the spine surgery are generally considered very good if you have a pinched nerve that's causing sciatic pain or the nerve down the leg. And the most common reason for that, again, is either narrowing of where the nerves run or stenosis or a disc herniation. These problems can be treated with microdiscectomy. And microdiscectomy basically is an operation where we make a very small incision in the lower part of the back, maybe an inch and a half, depends on the patient's size, or 3 to 4 centimeters. And then we come in through a small, with small retractors and under operating microscope, and essentially trim the part of the disc or the spine that's pressing on the nerves. And these can be done, again, can be done as an outpatient. They should have minimum blood loss, and can be done. A lot of patients spend the night, but patients could go home the same day if they are medically stable. And the outcomes are generally very good for getting rid of the nerve pain or sciatica.
That's great information. What advice would you give to our viewers as far as how to prevent spine injury and prolong their spine health?
So one of the issues that we see commonly now is that a lot of patients have had chronic symptoms for many months, many years sometimes, which without getting an opinion from a surgeon. So you may or may not be a candidate for surgery, but instead of taking narcotics long-term or receiving many, many injections over many months, then at some point you should get a consultation by a neurosurgeon or call Arkansas Surgical Hospital and see one of our surgeons. And then typically what we want is a new MRI, but we'd be glad to see you and order the MRI. Or you could have your family doctor order the MRI. If you cannot get an MRI, then you can get a CAT scan or other imaging studies to see whether or not there is a pressure on the nerve that can be fixed surgically. So one of the biggest issues is that we see patients that have had symptoms for a very long period of time. And those patients do respond to surgery, but instead of being on chronic narcotics for a long time and having severe pain for a long time, the outcomes are best if you get it treated earlier rather than many months or a year or two later. So my recommendation is if you have severe pain and you're not responding to these non-surgical treatments, then at minimum get an opinion from a surgeon to ask whether or not this is fixable or not. It doesn't necessarily mean you have to go through surgery, but at least you know your options. The best outcomes, again, are in people that have not been on long-term narcotics and have not had symptoms or nerve symptoms for a long period of time. You can get nerve damage and you can get chronic sciatica that doesn't always respond to surgery. So get an opinion, call Arkansas Surgical Hospital or go to your family doctor, and then go through, again, you can go through many, many non-surgical treatments, and then if you fail that, then consider surgery.
Well, Dr. Shahim, I appreciate you taking time to spend it with us and our viewers on Facebook Live. you have clinics outside of neurological surgery associates. You go.
We go to Conway Satellite Clinic and we go to Benton. And some of my partners go to El Dorado also for a visit.
Okay. If you would be interested in additional information about Dr. Shaheem or any of our physician specialists here at Arkansas Surgical Hospital, you can reach out to us at our referral assistance line, 800-901-0307, or you can go to our website, arksurgicalhospital.com. Thank you for spending this time with us. If you have any additional questions, you can reach out to us on our Facebook page or give us a call on the referral line.